Let's take a look at this integral together. We have the integral of x cubed over the quantity 4 minus x squared squared dx. Now, we suspect that this integral could be a good candidate for the technique of trig substitution because I see this quantity 4 minus x squared, which has the form a squared minus u squared. So let's try using trig substitution and see if it's going to help us in this situation. Now, our guidelines tell us that for quantities of this form, a squared minus u squared, we want to use a substitution u equals a sine of theta, where theta is restricted to values between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So in our case, looking at our expression, right, we have 4 minus x squared. So in our case then, a is 2 and u is x. So then in the end, the substitution I'm going to want to make, this u equals a sine of theta, is going to look like x equals 2 sine of theta. So that's the substitution I want to try, but just like with any other type of substitution, I also need to compute the derivative. So I need dx, which in this case, if I take the derivative, I get 2 cosine of theta d theta. So now I can go ahead and rewrite my integral so that it's in terms of theta. In the numerator here, I have x cubed. Okay, so that's going to become 2 sine of theta quantity cubed, and in the denominator I have 4 minus x squared quantity squared, so that's going to become 4 minus the quantity 2 sine of theta squared, all of that squared. And then for dx, I'm going to substitute 2 cosine of theta d theta. So let's do a little bit of work on simplifying this integral. On the top, if I actually cube 2 sine of theta, that's going to give me 8 sine cubed of theta. And then inside my brackets on the bottom here, let's go ahead and square 2 sine of theta. So we're going to have 4 minus 4 sine squared of theta, that whole quantity squared. And then I still have my times 2 cosine of theta d theta. Now, if we look closely at the bottom here, it looks like maybe we can use a Pythagorean identity to simplify that. So out to the side here, let's take a look. I have 4 minus 4 sine squared of theta. If I pull out a 4, I've got 4 times the quantity 1 minus sine squared of theta. And hopefully you recognize by now that 1 minus sine squared of theta is cosine squared of theta. So what I've got then is 4 times cosine squared of theta. So rewriting some more then, I have 8 sine cubed of theta over 4 cosine squared of theta, and that whole quantity is squared, and then times 2 cosine of theta d theta. If I actually square that denominator then, I've got 8 sine cubed of theta over 16 cosine to the fourth of theta times 2 cosine theta d theta. And now there's a bit more simplification I can do. Notice I have an 8 and a 2 in the top being multiplied together and a 16 in the bottom. That's going to give me 16 over 16, so I can cancel out all those constants. And then I have a cosine of theta in the top, 4 factors of cosine in the bottom. So that's going to leave me with 3 factors of cosine in the bottom, so it looks like in the end we're left with the integral of sine cubed of theta over cosine cubed of theta d theta. So now we have this integral to evaluate, an integral that involves trig functions. And we've seen some methods in the past for dealing with trigonometric integrals. So there are a few different ways we can approach this. One way is we could write this as tangent cubed of theta d theta. And then we could convert some tangents to some secants and go about it that way. But we can also just go right from this form where we have things in terms of sines and cosines, and do just a little bit of a normal u substitution here. So let's go ahead and try that. I'm not going to use u's since we used u up here. I'll say z instead. So I'm going to try letting z equal cosine of theta. Okay, so then the derivative of cosine, of course, is negative sine. So dz equals negative sine of theta d theta. Now, on the top here, I see that I actually have three factors of sine of theta. So it looks like maybe right off the bat, this isn't going to quite work out for us. But all we need to do is remember some of the tricks we used when we were learning about these trigonometric integrals. And one trick we can do is on the top here, I can leave aside a factor of sine of theta d theta to be my du. So then, of course, I'm going to have a sine squared of theta left. And then that sine squared of theta I can rewrite using a Pythagorean identity. So I could write that as 1 minus cosine squared of theta. So I end up with an integral that looks like this. And this looks like it actually might work with my substitution. So if I go through with that substitution, this 1 minus cosine squared of theta is going to become 1 minus z squared. Sine theta is dz with a negative symbol, so I'm just going to put that negative out front. And then on the bottom, I have cosine cubed, so that should just be z cubed. Okay, so now I have this integral here in terms of z. So we just kind of keep going from integral to integral here, and each one we have to remember a different technique that we've learned. Now this particular integral is going to be pretty easy if I just remember that I can split up this fraction. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep this negative out front of everything for a second, and I'm going to write this as the integral of 1 over z cubed dz minus the integral of z squared over z cubed dz. So let's follow through with this. So this first integral I can write as z to the negative 3 power dz. And then I've got minus, this is the integral of 1 over z dz. And I can very easily evaluate each of these integrals. So still keeping this negative out front, this is going to become z to the negative 2 over negative 2 minus the natural log of the absolute value of z. I'm going to stick a plus c out here. So if I distribute that negative, it looks like I'm going to end up with 1 over 2z squared plus the natural log of the absolute value of z plus c. Now let's go ahead and get things back in terms of theta. Remember that z was cosine of theta. So then this becomes 1 over 2 cosine squared of theta plus the natural log of the absolute value of cosine of theta plus c. So our last step then is going to be to go from thetas back to our original variable x. So if we scroll back up, we'll see that we said that x was equal to 2 sine of theta. So let's remind ourselves of that out to the side here. X was 2 sine of theta. But I'm interested in cosine of theta. So to figure out what cosine of theta is, I'm going to have to set up one of my right triangles. So I can write this as x over 2 equals sine of theta. And I set up a right triangle who has an angle theta with a sine of x over 2. So sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So my opposite side then should be x, and my hypotenuse should be 2. I can use Pythagorean theorem to solve for this other leg of the triangle. So I'll call this side B for a moment, and we can set up the relationship. X squared plus b squared equals 2 squared. So if I solve for b, I get b squared equals 4 minus x squared. So b is the square root of 4 minus x squared. And notice here that I'm taking the positive root. I'm able to do that in this case because of these restrictions on theta that go along with our substitution here. So I know now this adjacent leg of the triangle, which is going to allow me to simply write down what cosine of theta is. So cosine of theta in general is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So that should be the square root of 4 minus x squared over 2. So now that I know an expression for cosine of theta in terms of x, I can just quickly finish off my problem. So going from this previous line here, we can say that this expression equals, so I got this factor of 1/2, and then notice that I have a cosine squared here, but it's in the denominator. So I'm going to want to take the reciprocal of my cosine expression here. So this is going to be 1/2 times 2 over the square root of 4 minus x squared, and that's squared, and then plus the natural log of the absolute value of this expression once again for cosine. There are some small simplifications that could be done here, but we'll just leave it in this form, and this is our final answer.